A very good morning to one and all. Hope I'm audible to everybody. Yeah, we will be starting very soon in 1 minute. So here we go now. Good morning, one and all. Welcome to the Thermo Fisher Scientific webinar. We are the co-hosts for today's webinar. I am Ankit Kankar, and I'm the product manager for Biospectrum India. Biospectrum India edition and an online version was launched in March 2003, and it became India's first comprehensive biotech monthly magazine. Biospectrum provides comprehensive coverage of exciting happenings in life science, which includes biopharma, bioinformatics, bioindustrial, biosupplier in bioservices and healthcare domain as well. Biospectrum has emerged as the most preferred platform to engage the life science industry in India and Asia Pacific. Before we start the webinar, there are few house rules which I would like to take you through. All participants will be at listen-only mode. If you have any questions, please wait for our question and answer slide to pop up in the end. You can type your question and answer into the chat panel when the Q&A screen pop up. This webinar is available on demand on biospectrumindia.com for next 6 months. Today in this webinar, Thermo Fisher focusing on the methods which met all the requirements of current regulation, sensitivity and repeatability exceeded the expected requirements of the control limits. Consequently, delivering consistent results longer and achieve higher sample throughput with almost no downtime, making this analytical system especially suitable for the detection of trace genotoxic impurities in complex drug matrix. And our speaker for today's webinar is Dr. Sridhar Gowde, who is an application manager for GCMS portfolio in Thermo Fisher Scientific. Dr. Gowde worked with the pharma testing labs and analytical research and development labs at various positions like Medlar Lab, Cipla, Chemical R&D, Unicamp, Laboratories, Endocrinometries, as product and senior application scientist for chromatography, GC and LC at Perkin Elmer, India Private Limited before Thermo Fisher. So let me welcome, sir. Good morning, sir. Yeah, now you can take this forward.
Hello, everyone. Hello, everyone. Welcome to this special webinar on the nitrosamine impurities analysis by GCMS. As you must aware that there is a global crisis currently going on with the nitrosamine impurities in the ARV class of drugs. In this webinar, we'll be seeing the solution offered by Thermo Fisher Scientific to comply or meet the 2 days limits set by the FDA for nitrosamine impurities, but to meet the future requirement and also not limiting to ARV class of drugs. The Sartan crisis all started in June 2018. The first reporting of nitrosamine impurities was done by ZHP base out of China in June 2018. So first we'll see what are the Sartans or the ARBs. Angiotensin is a peptide hormone in our body that affects our cardiovascular system in various ways, including narrowing your blood vessels. This narrowing can increase your blood pressure and force your heart to work harder. Angiotensin 2 receptor blockers block the action of angiotensin and allows blood vessels to dilate. The angiotensin 2 receptor blockers helps to relax your blood vessels, which lowers your blood pressure and makes it easier for your heart to pump. Some of the most popular sartans are shown on these slides. As you can see, the tetrazole ring is the most common structure amongst all the sartans. Nitrosamine impurities are mutagenic in nature and can cause cancer or exposure. Since June 2018, several companies have recalled their drugs from the market in US and Europe. According to FDA, the risk was 1 in 8,000 people if you took the highest dose of one of the affected medicines. List for the nitrosamine impurities is growing steadily after the initial impurities of NDM and NDEA reported in June 2018. It is suspected that the nitrosamine impurities are formed during the synthesis of the tetrazole ring under certain conditions and when some specific solvent like DMF are used. The interim limits are now established by both FDA and EMA, and after which companies will have to demonstrate that there is no quantifiable levels of these impurities present in these drugs. The possible reaction which might be taking place as shown in this slide. Dialkyl formamides, dimethyl formamide or diethyl formamides are often contaminated by small amount of the corresponding dialkyl amines. They are well known to break down to give this dialkyl amine impurities under heating. These dialkyl amines in presence of sodium nitrite and under acidic conditions can give rise to these impurities levels. Even other class of drugs like the one shown in the proton pump inhibitors are also now routinely checked for the nitrosamine impurities because of the similar synthesis process. Even anti-diabetic drugs like pioglitazone was found to be contaminated with the nitrosamine impurities. The scope of the finding nitrosamine impurities is now ever expanding. And the limits are getting very strict. These are some of the interim limits and is based on the drug's maximum daily dose and the acceptable daily intake. Here we can see it is 0.3 ppm for NDMA in valsartan and so on as shown for the other ARBs in drugs. The US FDA has published several methods which are now available in the public domain. Broadly speaking, there are two techniques used. One is GCMS, the volatile species, and LCMS for the polar species like NMBA. Even though there are some LCMS methods established to cover all the impurities reported, GCMS is very popular mainly for the ease of use and the detection limits achieved for the volatile species. European pharmacopoeias now incorporated nitrosamine impurities in the monographs. After the implementation of these methods in the monograph, the manufacturing sites will have to test every batch of production for these impurity levels. As per the FDA published methods for GCMS, these are the two offerings from the Thermo Fisher Scientific. ISQ 7000 GCMS system, which is a single quadrupole system with the tri plus 500 headspace system. And other one is the triple quadrupole TSQ 9000 GCMS system with the RACE 1300 gas chromatography. The common features of all the MS is a very powerful and easy to use Chromeleon software. Chromeleon software is used for both single quad GCMS and triple quad GCMS and thermo LCMS and also for the conventional GC and HPLC detectors. Chromeleon software for the mass spectrometer has all the features to compliance as per 21 CFR Part 11 compliance and is one of the best user-friendly software available in the market today. It can also control multi-vendor GCs, HPLCs, and including GCMS and LCMS system from Thermo Fisher Scientific. The software also offers tools to make our MS-MS work simple and with easy-to-use method development tools like AutoSRM. The SimBridge tool in Chromeleon allows sim methods exported from other sources to be translated to the TSQ 9000 MS-MS system. Those sim methods can be immediately run on the TSQ 9000 system or through AutoSRM to translate the sim information into powerful SRM methods. This slide shows you the analytical details. In April 2019, the USFDA has published a method with the direct injection using GCMS-MS system to detect and quantify the total 5 impurities using an internal standard 10-nitroso-dimethylamine 13D6 labeled. This internal standard is used to correct the injection precision or any discrepancies that may arise due to sample preparation. In current analysis, the whole experiment is carried out without using any internal standard, and the external standard method is used for the quantification of these impurities in samples. AutoSRM is your own mass spectrometry method development expert integrated into your system. This software walks you through the development of fully optimized SIM target ions or SRM transition in very simple and efficient workflows. If you like to develop from your current SIM method, SimBridge seamlessly the workflow by improving your method details. Altogether, it is full MS or MS-MS method development independence even for the less experienced users. To optimize the response on TSQ 9000 series GCMS-MS system, the AutoSRM study was conducted on all the impurities, NDBA, NEIPA, NDIPA. Collision energy, the precursor ion and the product ions are optimized. This is one, it's shown for the NDBA impurities. This is the AutoSRM study for NEIPA impurity, and this is AutoSRM study for NDIPA impurity. To check the detection limit, various concentration level of the standards were injected, and based on the signal to noise ratio, the detection limit was established. The concentration level injected were in the range of 0.005 ppm, 0.001 ppm, and 0.005 ppm. Based on the signal to noise values obtained from the lowest concentration level injected, the results were summarized and compared with the LOD and LOQ limits reported in this method. From the comparative table, it is observed that we can able to achieve the LOD and LOQ level 8 to 10 times below the reported levels. The linearity plot for all 5 impurities to check the linearity factor based on the R square values injected in the range of 2 to 80 ppb. Correlation coefficient values were observed to be more than 0.999 for all the impurities without using any internal standard. Repeatability is also tested at the limit concentration of 40 ppb and for all the impurities, and the percentage RSD value was observed is less than 10% for all impurity levels. The Sartan API is also tested for the estimation of fine impurities with the spike recoveries, and the spike recoveries values calculated are observed to be within 70 to 120%. A similar kind of experiment was also planned using headspace GCMS system to check the instrument performance with respect to the method published by USFDA in Jan 2019, which is for the two impurities NDMA and NDEA. The linearity was plotted from 2 ppb to 180 ppb at different concentration level in replicate. The correlation coefficient value observed for both the impurities is more than 0.999. The repeatability is also tested at different concentration level. The percentage RSD value is observed less than 6% for all the different concentration level. This is one of the example of 5 ppb NDMA and NDEA standard injected by headspace GCMS system. The Valsartan API sample for the content of NDMA and NDEA is analyzed along with the recovery studies. Result obtained for recovery studies is in the range of 80 to 120%, and LOD and LOQ observed of 0.002 ppm and 0.005 ppm respectively. Based on the laboratory data analysis, it can be concluded that the Thermo Fisher Scientific is having a complete solution with the unique capabilities like sensitivity, ease of use, and fully compliant software. Based on the data, the system can go up to 8 to 10 times lower with the standard configuration of GCMS reported in the methods. Some of the unique features offered with the TSQ 9000 and ISQ 7000 GCMS systems, like the wireless source, no hassle for any connections, vacuum probe interlock for isolation of the source and column, and also used to maintain the vacuum in the analyzers, and the helium saver module, option to save the carrier gas consumptions. In this slide, the analyzer tray with the source and transfer optics is shown. It is designed, is based on the proven platform and used for all the thermo GCMS and GCMSM system. This is a standard extractor bright source, which is a source as without any wires. We can see on the right hand side the wires or connections in any standard GCMS system available in the market today. So there is no issue for any connections, so it will be easy to handle while cleaning and operation. During the course of analysis, the source needs to be routinely cleaned based upon the sample matrix and the number of samples analyzed. In extractor bright source, all the components of the source can be dismantled by hand and cleaned without any special tools or any special training required. The helium ion burns effectively eliminated due to the RF lines on the extractor bright source, and the analyzer part is not contaminated. The maintenance of the system becomes very easy, and the main part quadrupoles are remains clean for longer time. In TSQ 9000 system has an off-axis optics, thereby eliminating the neutral noise, and are removed before they enter the analytical quadrupole, which would be affected the sensitivity of the analysis. The Neverwind technology available is a key productivity tools in the Thermo Fisher Scientific GCMS-MS systems. TSQ 9000 system takes your GCMS uptime to the next level with the patented never vent technology. Using the vacuum probe interlock in conjunction with the extractor bright ion source, the new V-lock force plug maintenance operations such as source cleaning can be performed on the system without the need of vent of your mass spectrometer. With the new V-lock source plug, routine maintenance operations such as column changing can be performed on the system without the need of venting the mass spectrometer. This boosts instrument productivity to unprecedented levels, meaning time can be spent on producing quality results. Never vent reduces downtime and maximizes sample analysis. Your time can be spent on producing the quality results. Ion source maintenance or change of source with never vent technologies can save almost 4 hours of the time. Change of column can be done without using any microfluidic device and save almost 4 hours of your time. This is huge productivity benefit for the end users. Thermo Fisher can offer different products or different configuration based on the laboratory needs. Where you can see from 9000 no VPA to 9000K advanced EI source. In this Sartan analysis, we are using a standard extractor bright source with never vent technology so that the lab system can be used for the larger sample analysis with the best sensitivity reported. And this system can be fully upgradable at any time in the lifespan. Thermo Fisher Scientific is also offering customer a wide range of GCMS solutions capable to satisfy any requirement in terms of sensitivity and selectivity. Like GC conventional systems, which are modular, having a user changeable injector and detector modules. GC ovens designed for the fast heating and cooling for shorter cycle time with this Trace 1300 series GC. GCMS systems add increased sensitivity to handle the difficult matrices and higher level of interferences. ISQ 7000 is used for full scan and selected ion monitoring analysis for the targeted and untargeted screening for moderate complex matrices. TSQ 9000 MSMS capability to increase the selectivity when strong coalition with the matrix cause several interferences, and it is very popular for target analysis. High resolution mass specs like Q-exactive or DFS systems, which are used to increase selectivity through high mass resolution and for targeted and untargeted analysis, even in a complex sample matrices, and structure elucidation of the unknown compounds. Thank you. And if you have any queries or if you require any information, please contact us at analyze.in@thermofisher.com. Thank you.
Thank you so much, everybody, for your time. And I have a nice slide update from Thermo Fisher regarding the speaker busy slot. I request everybody to, drop their questions to analyze.in@thermofisher.com. Thank you.